Good evening, everyone, and thank you for tuning in to GSBA's first ever virtual scholars celebration. I'm thrilled to be your host for the evening. My name is Ernesto Alejandro Morfin Montesoca. I'm a fourth year GSBA Scholar alum, Duke University class of 2019. Joining the 30th anniversary Scholars Celebration Committee has been a roller coaster, as you can all imagine. What started with elaborate plans of indoor fireworks and confetti cannons quickly had to change gears into a virtual celebration. And I want to thank each person who served on the committee this year: Beth Osborne, Danny Cords, Lisa Sterrett, Jackie Vai Chow, and our amazing chair, Crystal Wilson. Tonight, you will get to help us cheer on our hardworking graduates, welcoming our largest group of new scholars ever, encouraging our returning scholars, and having an opportunity to give to make sure this program continues to grow and thrive as we look ahead to the next 30 years. Now, please welcome our fearless leader, GSBA President and CEO, Louise Chernin.
Hi, everyone. It's very hard to imagine, even just a few short months ago, that we would not be all together for the 30th anniversary Scholars Dinner. But here we are, celebrating virtually. We knew right away, even if we couldn't have a dinner in person, that nothing was going to stop us from celebrating our scholars. As you know, our scholars work very hard to get where they are, and we are their family. We are their extended family and their support. And so tonight, we're going to take some time out and cheer for them and be there for them so that they can have the support and feel the support they have for their family. Who would have thought this program started 30 years ago, by two amazing visionary people, Mary Ann Bailey and Linda Bakken, and they were shortly joined by Mike Shem and Rita Smith and Bob Dugosh and Dave Brown and Dean Sargent, amazing people who said, too many LGBTQ kids are thrown out of their homes. Too many of them can't go to school, can't go to a post-secondary school and get a college education. And they made a decision. They made a pledge that they were going to start the very first scholarship program for LGBTQ students in the United States. Started out with just two students, $2,500 each. And here we are, 30 years later, investing over $600,000 in the education of LGBTQ students. How did we do it? We did it because of you, our members, our donors, our LGBTQ and allied community. Thank you. Thank you for the years that you have given hope and education and a future to LGBTQ students. This year, we're so excited. 60 students are going to be supported this year. 60 students, 35 of them brand new. But unlike other scholarship programs, we're unique. We're backed by a community. We have a GSBA guarantee, which I believe is unheard of in a scholarship program, where you start out with GSBA and we will see you through up to 4 years of your education. We will be there for you just like a family. And so tonight, I ask you to join me to let your heart be full, to realize what impact we're having on so many lives. It's a hard time. I know it's a hard time for many of you, but think of our students, often without family support. Many of them who work in the hospitality industry, who've lost their jobs, struggling with rent and food security as well. Tonight, whatever you can do to give, starting tonight through June, I hope you will dig in, see if you can make a donation. Maybe you can do what you did last year, maybe even a little bit more if you're fortunate right now. But whatever you give, every penny will be used to support an LGBTQ student so that their hope, their education, and their future can be more secure because of your support. And trust me, we will all benefit because we need to have amazing leaders solve the very difficult problems we are all facing. So celebrate tonight, support our students, fill your hearts, and end this wonderful evening with a full heart, knowing that we're doing all we can for our students. Thank you.
Thank you, Louise. Before we jump into our program, we have some extra special words to share with you from Senator Patty Murray and Seattle Mayor Jenny Durkin.
Congratulations to this year's GSBA scholars. I know you've all worked incredibly hard over the past year and have very bright futures ahead. You are all part of such an important legacy with this program, the oldest LGBTQIA+ scholarship in the country, and this organization which has stood on the front lines of the community's long struggle for equality. During these uncertain times, it is important to find joy and celebrate our achievements. So as a proud partner to GSBA and our state's LGBTQIA+ community, I am so happy to see the continued success of this program, this organization, and all of you. I look forward to working together with all of you to continue building an inclusive state and community that welcomes all of us as we are, no matter who we are or who we choose to love. Thank you.
GSBA scholars, we are so sorry that you don't get a real graduation this year, but we want to congratulate you on your remarkable contributions. This is a really tough time to be navigating the world, but we know that this can be an opportunity for all of us to reshape the world in a more just, more vibrant place. You're going to play a great role in that. Our future is brighter because of you and the work you're going to do. So congratulations and good luck to all of you.
For those of you just tuning in, welcome to the 2020 Virtual GSBA Scholars Celebration. And now to share a few words about where the scholarship fund is heading is board member and GSBA Scholarship Fund Chair, Carrie Carson.
Thanks, Ernesto and Louise, and thanks to all of you for joining us tonight. I know I'm honored to serve as GSBA Scholarship Fund Chair and on the Board of Directors. Over the course of the past 30 years, GSBA has invested more than $4.5 million in 495 LGBTQ plus and allied students to help change our community and the world. This year, I'm so excited to welcome 35 new scholars, yes, 35, and 25 returning scholars for our largest cohort ever, 60 scholars. I'm also super excited to honor members of this year's graduating class. I could not be more proud of our 25 graduates who have persevered through hours and hours of Zoom classes to finish their degrees. As we know, many of these graduates will not have the opportunity to participate in their college graduation ceremonies in person. So please flood the comments box and join me in congratulating the class of 2020 graduates who are tuning in with us tonight. I'm so proud of all of you. Before we move on to our next guest this evening, I wanted to give you a quick update on how the GSBA Scholarship Program has been adapting to shifting scholar needs during these really challenging times. This year, with the generous support of the Beek Family Legacy Foundation, we were able to launch the Beek Family Open Arms Fund. This is available to scholars for one-time cash grants that can be used for rent or utilities, transportation costs, groceries, etc. Recognizing that a financial crisis can force a student to withdraw from classes, we are doing everything in our power to keep GSBA scholars in school to persist onward to graduation. In addition, we know that while we can't see each other in person, finding ways to connect is so important so that we don't feel alone. It's important to our mental and emotional health. With this in mind, GSBA Scholarship Fund staff have been reaching out to scholars frequently. We've been hosting virtual scholar hangouts over Zoom. We are so proud that this scholar-to-scholar community building and connection has become a significant aspect of the GSBA Scholarship Program over the past several years. This, in addition to the wider community of support that GSBA offers to our next generation of leaders, is what I think makes this program truly special. Because this is the 30th anniversary of the scholarship program, we wanted to check in with our first two scholars from 1991, Shinji and Heather. Hi, Shinji. Thanks for joining us tonight. How did you feel when you got that GSBA Scholarship Award? What were you excited about?
Oh, it was unbelievable to me. And also, I thought you know, I could be a good role model for the sexual minority young people, especially ethnic minorities.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing. Shinji, what are you up to now?
You know what? I don't know whether I could, you know, achieve my own goal at my age of 51. I've been doing a lot of things, especially people with HIV and AIDS. Yeah, And I'd like all the people in the world who are sexual minorities to be happier and living safer.
Thanks, Shinji. Now we're going to hear from Heather. Hi, Heather. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm hoping you could tell us about how you found out about the GSBA Scholarship Fund and how you applied.
Yeah, I was a junior in high school. I had just come out at high school, in my high school and at home, and I was basically kicked out of my home as a junior. And a good friend of mine at school knew what I was going through, and her mom actually offered to take me in and have me live with her so I could still continue to finish high school. And she was on the board of GSBA. And so she told me about the scholarship opportunity and encouraged me to apply.
When you first applied, did you have an interview? What was that experience like?
It was the very first time that they'd opened up the scholarship. So there weren't a ton of applicants, probably not as many as there are now. Then there was an interview process. For me, it was pretty intimidating because I was still in high school. I don't think I'd even gone on a job interview by then. And so I walked into this room and there was a table full of like very well put together professional people and one chair open for me in the middle of that table. And I remember being pretty intimidated, but they were super nice and made me feel really comfortable.
What message would you want to give to our current scholars and those graduating and our scholarship fund donors and supporters?
Getting a scholarship from GSBA really makes me want to be a very out and proud person because you have the support of this community who's helping you do great things. Stay involved with your community and try to give back as much as you've been given. I was kicked out of the house, like that was my family. So it's basically like supporting your family.
I'm so proud to transfer back to Ernesto. He and I had a great experience at the Leadership Academy a few years ago on a woods walk talking about different topics. And he's such an amazing person that's going to do wonderful things for our community and for the community at large. So Ernesto, please take it away and thank you.
Thank you, Carrie. That walk was something that made the leadership retreat very special. And thanks to Shinji and Heather too. I guess I have my work cut out for me. I'm expecting GSBA to bring this video out of the archive for my 30 years post-scholarship interview in 2049. Next, please join me in cheering for our 2020 cohort of returning scholars.
My name is Amanda Singelis.
My name's Honorink.
My name is Astro.
My name is B. McVicker.
My name is Kashayla Rogers.
Hi, my name is Elle Harwood.
My name is Elise Decker.
My name is Fatima Al-Rikabi.
My name is Fia Louia, Titi Timme, Namuxitele.
Hi, my name is Ines Marti.
My name is Keegan Samboniego.
Hi, I'm Kevin Alexander Estrada Alamo.
I'm Leo McLeod.
I'm Leo.
Hi, my name is Magdalena.
I'm Manny Lopez.
Hi, I'm Nate Joe.
My name is Nicole Vargas.
Hi, my name is Nick Takahashi.
My name's Quinn.
My name is Ro Boyce.
My name is Ro Fastidi.
What it means for me to be a GSBA scholarship recipient.
It means I could prove myself to my family and prove that all their hard work was worth it.
It means that I finally get to fulfill a dream of mine to go to college.
I come from a background of foster care, and to have not only this money, but such a great community behind me and this overall acceptance means a lot to me.
Your impact is gonna help me further my career goals of fighting infectious diseases.
This scholarship is life-changing for me. It gives me the opportunity to know that I'm worthy and I'm enough.
I really wouldn't be able to go to the school I go to and get the education I'm getting if it wasn't for you. So from the bottom of my heart and the bottom of the hearts of all of my family members, thank you.
We'll be right back. Wow, what a great looking group. Now we'll hear a little bit more in depth from third year scholar Nate Joe.
Hi, I'm Nate Joe, and I use they, them pronouns. I grew up in Eastern Washington in a very religious and conservative family that was not understanding or accepting of my identity. And when I decided to go to Western Washington University, I was told that I would receive no support. Without the GSBA scholarship, I actually wouldn't be able to attend college. Being a GSBA scholar, to me, means community and family. Hearing the scholars' stories and understanding mine in the context of being a part of this community is so empowering and has changed my life and inspired me to do things that I would have otherwise never dared to do. My experience at Western has been so amazing. Last year, I was elected as the first ever and only first-year student to be on the Associated Students Board of Directors. I think the most important thing that I've learned throughout the last year is that queer people have always existed, and queer people have always been powerful. The power that queer people have to see things differently and to change things. Because when you can change the way that you see the world, you can change the world that you see. So to every GSBA supporter, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Thank you for sending me to college to allow me to connect with our community, to fight for our community, and to create a better future for tomorrow.
Here's my friend, Nate Joe, joining us live to share a little bit more about their journey.
Hi everyone, my name is Nate and I use they, them pronouns. I'm so disappointed not to be in Seattle sharing great food and conversation with you all right now, but please know that each of you is in my heart, and I'm so thankful to share this moment of community with you, no matter where you are in the world. Okay, my story. So, the first 19 years of my life did not seem remarkable when I lived them, and it's only in reflection that I wonder how I even survived. Imagine that your life is shut behind a cold steel door. Every person, every institution, every day, adding another padlock to ensure that you'll never escape. This was the first 19 years of my life. My church told me that the only way to be happy was conformity to the strictest and most suffocating ways of being. My father told me that I would be thrown out if I ever had a boyfriend, and my mother told me that I was going to hell. My school taught me that the only way to be safe was to hide all the best parts of myself. But beneath the survival, the terror, and the emotional abuse, a whisper of light grew inside me. I couldn't see beyond the door that locked away my life, but I could close my eyes and look inside to see the wild, free, rainbow magic swirling inside me, clamoring for liberation. When it was time for me to decide on a college, my mom gave me a very short list to pick from. All the colleges on her list were also on the list of most anti-LGBTQ colleges in the nation, places where I could be expelled just for being openly gay. Instead, I chose Western, and I believe my mom's exact words were, "I won't pay a single cent into that liberal institution." This was intended to be the final lock on a door. With no financial aid, no ability to take out loans, and no parental support, it seemed like I would be stuck behind those locks for forever. But my GSBA scholarship was a key that fell from heaven. It allowed me to smash through that door, escape, and begin my new life. My first GSBA Leadership Immersion Weekend on Bainbridge Island, surrounded by 50 of the most brilliant, passionate LGBTQ students, was the first time I knew what safety and community felt like. My fellow scholars ignited the light inside my heart and determination to shape the future of our communities. And in September of last year, with my tiny little car exploding with all my belongings, I made the trek from Eastern Washington to Bellingham and moved myself into the dorm. I got a job at the Associated Students, and then, in a special election, I became the only freshman ever elected to the AS Board of Directors in Western's history. And I'm excited to share with you all tonight that a couple weeks ago I was elected to be the next student body president of Western Washington University. In this role, I'm excited to plan for and secure funding for Western's first fully accessible, multi-occupancy, gender-neutral bathroom, revitalize the AS Scholarship Program in recognition of the impact that scholarships have had on my life, and continue to advocate for the needs of LGBTQ students and students of color. This is all possible only because of my GSBA scholarship means that I get to spend my time leading, serving, and learning instead of just surviving. Every dollar that was ever donated to the scholarship fund, every minute volunteered at events, every person who supported a scholar is a promise for a future that we cannot yet fully see. In the midst of a collective meltdown of our society, weaponized politics, and growing hate, I do not have hope for our future because of our government. I do not have hope for our future because of politicians. I believe in our future because of you, because of the light inside of me, because of us, because the voices of the scholars you see tonight are the voices of the future, because Nolan is tackling the biggest environmental issues, and Zoe is reclaiming LGBTQ history and faith, and Ryan's work in public health is going to heal our communities, and Shannon's visibility as an out queer astronaut inspires everyone she meets. The GSBA scholars that I named are only four among generations and generations of past and future scholars who are changing the world. So in closing, I want to share the gratitude, hope, and love I have for all of you and my fellow GSBA scholars. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for being here for me. I am only here because of you. In this trying time, may we remind ourselves that a brighter future does not come from the magnificent actions of a few leaders, but from each of us believing that every act of good brings us closer to a future of justice, queer power, and peace for all beings. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing your story, Nate. And congrats to you on a successful campaign, future president. I know all of us watching would love to see your name on a ballot someday. Here's hoping. Next, we want to introduce to you third-year GSBA scholar, Amanda Singelis.
My name is Amanda Singelis. I want to become a high school English teacher, and I want to write novels that incorporate and center queer characters and LGBTQ characters to give us representation as we grow up. I would be the type to, like, when your mom says go to bed, I would hide under my pillow and then get caught with a flashlight 2 a.m. reading a book. From there, I grew from a reader to a writer, and I love the art of words and communication and people, and so all of those things, including my identity, make that what I want to do. I recently got offered a TA position as an LGBTQ student for a literature class, and I'm quite excited for that, to be a voice in the community. Being a GSBA scholar, I got the support and the community that I needed to come out this year. Joining the GSBA, it made coming out feel like home. I didn't necessarily have the full support system outside of the GSBA that I needed prior to this. To all the supporters, donors, and community ally members of the GSBA and LGBTQ community, I just want to thank you guys for the love and support that you've given me. We love you, and you are the reason for many of us why we get an education, why our voices become amplified, and why we feel we matter in our city, in our state, and in our world.
Congrats on your coming out journey, Amanda. This year, our scholarship selection process was much different from the one I experienced. 115 volunteers conducted virtual interviews with 94 scholarship finalists and selected 35 new scholars, our largest incoming cohort ever. Congratulations to these 35 new scholars. We look forward to meeting you and connecting with you in person in the future. Welcome to the GSBA Scholarship family. And without further ado, here they are.
Hello everyone, my name is Jesus Grajales, and I am a nursing student attending Heritage University.
My name is Bryant Allen. I'm finishing up my prerequisites at Cascadia College to become a chiropractor.
I'm Katie Wehrman. I'm going to Smith College this fall, and I'm hoping to major in psychology, and I'll also be swimming for them.
Hi, my name is Siobhan U, and I am a first-generation Cambodian-American student studying nursing at the University of Portland and also a minor in neuroscience. I use the pronouns he, him, his, and I'm excited for my sophomore year in college.
Hi, my name is Dawson Dang, and I'm studying nursing at the University of Washington.
My name is Ranulfo Molina. I'm currently at Western Washington University. I'm studying creative writing and a minor in education and social justice.
My name is Issa Jolie, and I'm studying queer ecology at Western Washington University.
My name is James McCandy, and I will hopefully be studying economics and business at Columbia University.
My name is June Amundsen. I use they, them pronouns, and I'm going to be studying biology and queer studies at Western Washington University.
Hi, I'm Abigail Smith, and I'm planning on studying mathematics and going to the University of Washington.
I'm Kendrick Jackson. I am entering my third year at Western Washington University, and I'm studying sociology as well as human services.
Hi, my name is Lisa, and I'll be studying computer science at the Pacific University.
Hi, my name is Mila. I go to the University of Washington, and I study computer science.
Hello everyone, I am Omid Asadi. I am studying healthcare informatics in Bellevue College.
My name is Fuku Shan, and I will go to University of Washington Seattle campus to study community environment planning.
My name is Robin Hardwick. My pronouns are he, him, and I am a sociology major at Reed College.
My name is Samantha Ayers. I use she, her pronouns, and I will be studying communications at Shoreline Community College.
My name is Tiffany Ashton Gatsby. I use all pronouns. I am studying at the University of Washington. I'm double majoring in medical anthropology, global health, and interdisciplinary visual arts.
My name is Alexander Pacheco, and I'm going to major in art education and minor in child psychology at Eastern Washington University.
My name is Ellie Spencer. I'll be studying business with a minor in French at the University of Washington next fall.
My name is Brian Jose Rincon Ochoa. I'm studying business administration at North Seattle College.
My name is Jace Reyes. My pronouns are he, him, and I'm studying sociology at the University of Washington.
My name is Jesse Reedy, and I'll be attending the University of Washington and hope to study communications.
I'm Lindsay McCarley. I am studying electrical engineering at Western Washington University.
Hi, my name is Eric Orozco. I'm going to be studying nursing or public health, and I am going to Washington State University.
My name is Sam Lissette Brown, and I am studying cognitive science at Tufts University.
My name is Jay Scrubs, and I am studying psychology at University of Washington, Tacoma.
I'm Bea Fenner, and I am studying psychology with a minor in women's gender and sexuality studies at Western Washington University.
I'm Casey Williams, and I'm studying pre-law at the Evergreen State College.
My name is Jay Sensian, and I use he, him pronouns, or they, them. And I'm studying social work and social welfare at Seattle University.
My name is Isabella Richter de Medeiros. I am studying cinema and sociology at Willamette University.
Hi, my name is Marlon Ducoto. I'm a GSBA graduate scholar. I will be studying quantitative management at Duke University.
If anyone listening is interested, I highly encourage you to serve on our scholarship interview team next fall. And now to share a few words is one of our newly minted scholars, Brian Rincon Ochoa.
My family and I immigrated from Mexico to the United States, where we have now been living for the last 15 years. Growing up in Natchez, Washington, as a non-English speaking gay man, I learned about social issues and social barriers firsthand for about 10 years, which is why I'm dedicating my education and my career to addressing those social issues and barriers. I am currently studying business administration at North Seattle College. I plan to transfer to the University of Washington, where I will continue my education in business administration while fulfilling the prerequisites for dental school. Throughout my undergrad, I will take courses that address social issues within the LGBTQ community and how those issues create barriers for somebody wanting to receive healthcare. My goal is to obtain a DMD DO degree, which would allow me to perform surgeries, provide dental care, provide primary care services, and teach. This scholarship reinforces my educational goals and dreams. This scholarship also ensures that I have the financial support to be able to continue my education. But the scholarship is not just about the financial benefit. Instead, it's about the support I am receiving from my community. This scholarship is about the thousands of donors, volunteers, and employees who are rooting for me. I do not feel alone in this journey of mine. I now have a group of people who are behind me, lifting me up. I believe that everyone associated with the GSBA believes that the work I will do through education will change the LGBTQ community and those that are underserved. I'm the first person in my family to be pursuing higher education, which has many challenges of its own. But I know that my presence in this system is paving the road for other students like myself. I'm passionate about obtaining a degree because I know it's the most effective way to change the world for the better. As a student right now, I can acknowledge the many faults within the medical, educational, and government system. My biggest hope for the future are my fellow classmates and the upcoming class. These students are equipped to handle social issues. They're intelligent, compassionate, caring, and risk takers, which will begin to replace professionals that refuse to be all of that. I hope that this new generation of professionals will begin to change the world and pave the way for social equity. Today, we have more and more queer, transgender, and people of color who seek higher education. Soon, these people are going to fulfill job positions that will allow them to change the lives of many people. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your willingness to share tonight, Brian. We're so excited to have you aboard. And now I'd like to welcome GSBA Scholar alum, GSBA board member, and Scholar Celebration Committee member, Danny Cords.
Hello, my name is Danny Cords, 2013 recipient of the David Barzilai GSBA Scholarship, Ruby Slipper donor, and current GSBA board member for Years Strong. Let me share my story about my scholarship. I was a 25-year-old high school dropout with not much self-worth when I applied for my scholarship. Though I loved performing, I hated public speaking because it required me to share myself, and I had been conditioned to hate myself through years of sexual orientation change efforts, which we called in my household reparative therapy. Now, from day one, the GSBA community helped me flip the narrative. And from day one, I felt the support of a powerful community and began to connect to the value that you saw in me. And suddenly, I was thrust into a supportive community where I was asked to share my truth. I felt validation and support speaking at the TASTE, the Scholars Dinner, and connecting with so many others that shared stories similar to mine. And together we shined a light into the shadows where I was empowered to share my truth, and I learned that what once was my deepest shame was actually one of my biggest assets in leadership. And you'll hear this often. The dollars may have given access to the classroom, but the GSBA community introduced me to my voice. In 2014, the GSBA teamed up with Senator Marco Elias to support the banning of sexual orientation change efforts in Washington state. I was able to be there in the Senate, testifying and sharing my truth. By 2016, just 3 years after my scholarship, I earned 3 degrees, including my master's in adult education and organizational development. In 2018, 5 years after my scholarship, I stood alongside Senator Elias, the GSBA, and Governor Inslee as he signed into law a ban that criminalized the very abuse I had experienced. And today, 7 years later, I am a professional public speaker for the Virtuoso Travel Network, a consultant in change management and disruption, and a passionate board member and donor. Dollars got me in the door. You, our community, supported my success. But we need dollars to get in the door. That is why I am personally donating tonight and why I am indebted to the amazing volunteers and donors who stood up amidst the COVID disruption to demonstrate your commitment to investing in tomorrow's leader. So whether you can give $1 or $10,000, your support will change someone's life forever. We've made it easier than ever to donate. If you want to make a one-time donation, it's simple as texting SCHOLARS to 243-725, which will send you a link straight to our Scholar Celebration giving page on a mobile-friendly platform. If you'd like to set up a monthly gift, please go to our website at thegsba.org. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Danny. Have any of you watching ever thought that you might want to go one step further than a gift tonight and start your own name scholarship fund? Here to talk more about taking this next step is GSBA Virtual Scholars Celebration Chair, Crystal Wilson.
Thank you so much for having me tonight, Ernesto. My name is Crystal Wilson. I'm delighted to be your Scholars Dinner Chair this year. With the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic, our dinner planning committee quickly switched gears to reimagine how we could honor and celebrate our scholars in a virtual event. I want to thank everyone on the committee for their passion and creativity in making this event a reality. As well, a tremendous thank you to the GSBA staff. As always, you do heroic work. And I want to thank all of you for tuning in with me tonight. We are all faced with many challenges now, and our students are especially hard hit. Your support tonight makes a difference in making sure that we can continue to support these future leaders. And it's so important to let our scholars know that we support them, not just with dollars, but also with our spirit. We've asked all of our scholars to be tuned in tonight, so please give them a shout out in the Facebook chat comments so they know you're watching. You know, GSBA has been blessed to have donors who have created scholarships to honor and memorialize family members and loved ones. These named scholarships provide funds and a connection to a legacy in the community and helps write our stories for future generations. Tonight, I'm pleased to present these GSBA named scholarship recipients. Attending the University of Washington, receiving the Kenny Olson and John Reed Scholarship, Dawson Dang. Attending Loyola Marymount University, receiving the L. Robb Memorial Scholarship, Magdalena Pink Sanchez. Attending Western Washington University and receiving the Tolkien Gaspari Family Scholarship, Lindsay McCarley. Attending Columbia Basin College, receiving the Beeks Family Legacy Scholarship, B. McVicker. Attending Seattle Central College and receiving the Giblet Family Memorial Scholarship, Kushela Rogers. Attending Evergreen State College and receiving the Rachel Miller Scholarship, Marina Westendorf. Attending Western Washington University and receiving the Sandy Peterson Memorial Scholarship, Fiulia Lemosetele. Attending the University of Washington and receiving the Chester Pulvedowski Scholarship, Fatima Al-Rakabi. Attending the University of Washington and receiving the Thomas R. and Mary Yetman Memorial Scholarship, Roe Boyce. Also attending the University of Washington, receiving the David Barzilai Memorial Scholarship, Tiffany Ashton Gadsby. Attending Heritage University and receiving the Richard C. Rolfe Scholarship, Jesus Grijalis. Attending Western Washington University, receiving the Ocals Memorial Scholarship, President-elect Nate Joe. Attending the University of Washington and receiving the Glenn Johnson and Michael Mulanson Bright Horizon Scholarship, Manny Lopez. Attending the University of Washington and receiving the C. White Reed Scholarship, Leo McLeod. Attending the University of Portland and receiving the Wazumi Family Scholarship, Siobhan Wu. And attending Pacific Lutheran University, receiving our Founders Scholarship, Amanda Singelis. We'll be sharing the story of each of these scholarships and the people who inspired and created them on our blog and in social media throughout the year. If you would like to discuss starting your own named scholarship fund with the GSBA, we would love to talk with you more about what this looks like. Please send an email to Mark R at thegsba.org. That's what my friend Mike and I did last year. Mike and I became friends over 30 years ago while working together in Microsoft Finance. He is my brother from another mother and one of the great loves of my life. Starting a scholarship with him was the only way I was going to get him to hyphenate his name with mine. So we started a scholarship. This year is our first scholar recipient, and we are honoring a student from a rural community. So now is the moment that I've been waiting for months. It is my great honor to present one last named scholarship recipient, the first Novejo Wilson Scholarship recipient, Novejo-Wilson Scholarship, Abigail Smith. Congratulations, Abby. We look forward to meeting you this fall when you come to Seattle to attend the University of Washington. To all of our 35 new scholars joining us this year, welcome to the GSBA community. And to all 60 of our scholars, congratulations. We are so proud of you, and we cannot wait to see what's next. Thank you so much, and back to you, Ernesto.
Thank you, Crystal. It's been so great getting to know you more through this committee. You've been a phenomenal leader, and you put in a tremendous amount of work to make tonight successful. From the bottom of my heart, thank you. On top of generous individual name funds, like the one Crystal and Mike started, we have several corporate partners who have created scholarships at the GSBA. Here is Trinity Parker of Symetra to introduce this year's corporate name scholarship recipients, including the very first three students to receive the Symetra Empowers Scholarship.
Thank you so much for having me tonight, Ernesto. My name is Trinity Parker, and I serve as Senior Vice President of Marketing, Communications, and Public Affairs at Symetra. I am proud to represent Symetra in announcing the names of new corporate scholarships and this amazing group of students who are tonight's recipients. We are thrilled to partner with GSBA to help these students reach their fullest potential. At Symetra, we are committed to advancing diversity, equity, and inclusion in our company and working with community-based organizations like the GSBA who share those same values. Tonight, I'm pleased to present the GSBA Corporate Name Scholarship recipients. Attending the University of Rochester and receiving the hashtag BU T-Mobile Scholarship is Yvonne Mahesh. Attending Seattle Central College and receiving the Olympic Hot Tub Scholarship is Astro Pittman. Attending Washington State University and receiving the Sounders SD Scholarship, Jesse Reedy. Attending Duke University as one of our graduate scholars, receiving the Wells Fargo Scholarship, Marlon Dokoto. Attending Tufts University and receiving the Microsoft Scholarship, Sam Lissette Brown. And attending the University of Washington and also receiving the Microsoft Scholarship, Mila Zuniga. Congratulations to these scholars. Symetra's gift to the GSBA Scholarship Fund was our first and largest Symetra Empowers Communities grant and reflects our deep respect for the opportunity the program provides LGBTQ and allied students. These new scholarships not only offer financial support for college, but provide leadership skills and an incredible network that will foster success over a lifetime. It is my honor to present the first three Symetra Empowers Scholarship recipients. Attending Bellevue College, Omid Asadi. Attending Perry Technical Institute, Monique Herrera. And attending the University of Washington, Ellie Spencer. Congratulations to all of the scholarship awardees. You have worked so hard, and we can't wait to see what you accomplish. Now, back to you, Ernesto.
Thank you, Trinity. GSBA will be sharing more in-depth stories about all our named scholarships over the next several months. So be sure to follow GSBA on Facebook and check out our blog. We now invite you to join us as we celebrate your 2020 GSBA graduating scholars. Congratulations to all of you. And don't be afraid if GSBA comes up and taps you on the shoulder to speak or MC next year's event. It's actually really fun. And now we have a video shot at last year's Leadership Immersion Weekend from graduating GSBA scholar, Richard Bada.
I'm Richard Parra. I come from an area that's nicknamed Fintucky, Finley. It's very conservative. Everyone there is very homophobic, sexist, and racist. I was always very alone, and I was the only one from my high school to actually go to UW. I'm majoring in bioengineering with honors, I just found out, with a focus on cell systems and tissues, and I'm double minoring in mathematics and diversity. I come from a low-income family, so just having this financial support has been incredible. I've had a really great experience at UW, just amazing community that I've been able to build. This summer, I am working with the College of Engineering with their youth summer programs. We're helping get underrepresented minority students into the College of Engineering and then helping them succeed once they're in there. The ultimate goal is to get a PhD in bioengineering because I would ultimately like to be a university professor. I've always loved teaching. Ever since I was a little kid, I would just like gather up my cousins and like we would play school and I'd be the like headmaster, just like teaching them whatever I'd learned in school that day. In the future, I want to have my own research lab so I can be the PI and I can help get more underrepresented minority students into higher education, into the STEM field, and into academia. Being a GSBA scholar is all about empowerment, knowing that there's people in my corner who have my back, who will help me succeed and reach my dreams. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you times infinity. Honestly, I will never be able to express the gratitude I feel. There are no words, honestly. Really none come to mind for me to be able to express how thankful I truly feel.
Thank you, Richard. It means so much to hear your story. Next up, we have a few words from someone that I've had the pleasure of meeting through GSBA. Here's graduating scholar Meilani Eyre.
Good evening, everybody. It's nice to see you all. Graduating during this time is a tremendous feat. The past few years have been hard, to say the least. And I definitely didn't think I'd make it through at certain times, but I'm here. And thanks to GSBA, I'm graduating on time, completely debt-free. Right now, the present is pretty chaotic, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty worried, but I'm not scared for the future. The future is where change happens, and we're the ones who are going to make that change. That work starts with us right now, because things can't stay the same. They have to change, and they will, because we're here. I also want to say thank you to all the scholars, new and returning. I didn't know what true acceptance really felt like before I came to the GSBA. I've always been the weird kid, and finding a place to belong always felt like a challenge. I always felt like I was just invited to somebody's birthday party because I was in their class, not because I was their friend. But I didn't feel that way with GSBA. When I went to the Scholars Retreat for the first time, I was met with open arms immediately. Everybody was so warm, and I felt so happy while I was there. I didn't have to second guess anybody's intentions because I could see that they were being their true self. And I actually believed for the first time when somebody said, "You're doing amazing things," because of how true and authentic everybody was. As a scholar, I've learned how to accept myself radically and love myself and my community. I learned that leading doesn't always look like marching in a protest or starting a nonprofit. Sometimes it's just giving people their voice back. And that's what GSBA did to me. They gave me my voice back. Thank you, GSBA. I could not be the person I am now had I not been invited to this family.
Thank you, Meilani. I can't wait to see all the amazing things you'll do. And now, we have some special words from community leaders to cheer you on since they couldn't be here with you in person.
Hi, I'm Justice G. Helen Whitener. Congratulations to all of the scholars. You are our hope for the future, and we need you now more than ever. I believe in you. And I wish each and every one of you continued success as you move forward. Well done.
Congratulations to those of you who are graduating and those of you who are in the latest cohort of scholars. Your continued success will make our city and our world a better place, and we are so inspired by what you have accomplished. Congratulations, and thank you for being you.
Hello to our GSBA scholars, and particularly to those of you in the class of 2020. We send you our best wishes as you take steps into a really uncertain world. The good news about our scholars is you already have demonstrated resiliency and courage in the face of challenges in your life. You are well prepared for this moment, and I know that you are poised to be the next generation of our leaders, and we are excited for the contributions you will make to our state and to our global community. To the returning scholars and to our new scholars, this is an unprecedented moment in our state and in our society. And the education and the learning you are doing right now, just like our 2020 scholars, will prepare you for a new world, a changed world. So proud of the stories and backgrounds and journeys that have brought you to this moment. We look forward to supporting you in this remaining journey ahead in your education, and excited to be a part of the team of cheerleaders who are here propelling you on to greatness and to more opportunities. To being the intersectional leaders that our state, our communities, that our world demand in this moment. And just as a community leader here in Washington, excited to welcome you, excited to encourage you in the journey ahead, and thank you for the courage and determination you've shown in pursuing this journey of education.
This event might not be what any of us expected a couple months ago, but how amazing that we were able to capture so many messages of hope and support as you all continue on in your education. Thank you all for tuning in tonight. If you asked me 5 years ago whether I'd be back on the stage as the MC, I would have thought you were crazy, but it's been an amazing journey. Thank you so much to every GSBA member who supported me. If you were able to make a donation tonight, thank you. Please share our mission with family and friends. Our scholars depend on this community of support to be able to become the leaders we need to make the world a better place. With that, I'd like to have second year GSBA scholar Inez Marti close us out with a song.
We are phones and then I'll be ready. Are you ready? It's the start of us waking up. Come on. Are you ready? I'll be ready. I don't want control. I want to let go.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I wish everyone safe travels from their living room to their bedroom. Stay safe, stay healthy, and good night.
This is Lori Jenkins, the first out lesbian serving as Speaker of the House in Washington State. I hope that someday one of you 60 scholars is serving in this role. But I want to just right now thank you for the work that you've done and congratulate you on everything you've done to get where you're at right now. In this time that we're in, we really need incredible leaders, and we need young people to see a vision that maybe others can't see right now. You are the people who are going to do that for us. You'll move us ahead, and I know we've got many graduates, 25 of them that you're recognizing this year. The graduates and as well as the scholars that are being honored tonight are gonna move us forward. And I am so proud to see you span out all over Washington State and the nation and bring your incredible skills over the years to come. Goodness knows we're going to need every single one of you. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Joe McDermott, King County Council member, and I want to give my warmest congratulations to everyone receiving scholarships this year. Whether you're a new scholarship recipient, or whether you're a graduating scholar, or whether you're in the middle of your studies, in the middle of this pandemic, I want to offer my congratulations and encouragement to every single one of you. You're doing excellent work in very trying times. As we learn to work from home, learn remotely, and do all of this in the middle of a pandemic, we're all trying new things. You're resilient, and your leadership will lead this region, this community, and the LGBTQ plus community very well for years to come. I couldn't be more confident in our future. Thank you and congratulations.
I'm Stephanie Dallas, GSBA Board Chair, and I am here with the rest of the board. We have something we want to tell all of our returning and our new scholars. So here it is, all together now.
Congratulations!
Yay! Woo! Scholars. I am Manny Santiago, Executive Director of the Washington State LGBTQ Commission, and I am here just to say congratulations. You did it. We are so proud of you. We are here with you. We can't believe that, that we're going through these really hard times, but yet we can be celebrating with you even at the distance. We are so proud of you. We can't wait for the time when we can actually come together and celebrate with each other and celebrate your successes and celebrate all the things that you have done. You are the leaders of our state. You are the leaders of our community. You are the leaders of our movement. Not only in the future, you're the leaders now. As a first generation myself, first generation here in the United States and also first generation graduate, I am so looking forward to the things that you are going to bring to our community. I want to reaffirm that the LGBTQ Commission is here for you. We are here to support you in whichever way you need it. And honestly, we can't wait to see what comes next. Mi gente latina que son estudiantes de este programa, muchas felicidades. Estoy muy orgulloso de nuestra comunidad. Estoy muy orgulloso de las cosas que han podido lograr. Y estamos aquí para ustedes. Thank you so much for all the work that you do. Thank you, GSBA, for supporting our students. And we look forward to celebrating with you soon in person. In the meantime, congratulations. Felicidades. Keep going. You are awesome.
Congratulations to the class of 2020 and to all our GSBA scholarship cohort members. You all are fantastic. You pushed through and you did it. To the class of 2020, whether you're finding a small ceremony to walk across the stage or if you plan to virtually watch your ceremony, know that you beat all odds and you completed that goal. And for that, we're extremely proud of you and always honored to be able to support and stand along you as you continue to do all the amazing things that you will do in this lifetime. To the scholarship, to the GSBA cohorts, past, present, and future, we are here for you always. We will stand next to you, in front of you, beside you, behind you, and hold you up in a lot of different ways. We, of course, are living through a new normal, a different time. And with that, we've always been able to survive and push through as a community. And we will always continue to do that. So GSBA Scholarship Cohort, Class of 2020, congratulations. And see you all outside of a screen.